Hi, this is Robin from the YouTube channel 8-Bit Show and Tell and from the podcast Growing Up 80s. And I've got a few memories about emulators with a focus on almost not only emulators of retro hardware, but retro hardware running emulators. The first emulator I ever remember seeing or hearing about was for the Commodore 64, and it was a PET emulator, Commodore PET emulator. It was far from perfect, but it, as best it could, reconfigured the C64 to match the memory map of the PET and allowed some PET software to be run on it. The main thing it did, I think, was relocate screen memory to the same location as the PET, but it did a few other things as well, I believe. It wasn't really an emulation, but it was configuring the 64 as close as possible to match the PET. It was pretty cool that be able to run some of those PET basic games and so on. And then some years later, when I got my Amiga, all kinds of emulators started coming out for that. And that seems to me to be where the emulation scene really began. Now, the Amiga was too slow to really emulate a lot of things very well, but it was worth a try. It was, I don't know how often it was actually useful, but it was still fun to play with. There was a Mac emulator for the Amiga, and that ran quite well, considering. And that was pretty exciting the first time I got that working. And then also there was an Atari ST emulator. And so both the Mac and the Atari ST were relatively easy for the Amiga to emulate because it had superior video hardware and it had the same processor. So I believe that the 68000 in the Amiga could directly run a lot of the Mac and Atari ST software, so it didn't need to slow down. It was running the code directly, but of course it would have to have some hooks in there to catch the video updates, disk like I/O, and so on. What I was more interested in were the Commodore 64 emulators. Now, I went from the Commodore 64 to the Amiga, and especially in those earlier years of the Amiga, I actually didn't have all that many games at first. So the idea of a C64 emulator was exciting. Now it turned out that C64 was even harder for the Amiga to emulate than the Atari ST or the Mac. It was, you wouldn't think so, but because of how the C64's video and sound chips, its custom chips, work, it was actually way more work for the Amiga to try and emulate those. And it didn't do all that good a job. When it was exciting to see that blue screen, the blue screen come up on the 64 with the ready prompt. But when I started typing on it, it was so slow you'd press a key and you'd wait for that key to appear. It would take, it felt like several seconds. It was probably 1 second, but that gave me an idea of how slow this was going to be. And then I tried to run games on it and it was so, it just was not fun. But it was pretty exciting. I think there were at least three C64 emulators for the Amiga. ReadySoft released one called the 64 emulator. And then another one, I had to look this one up on the internet. Software Insight Systems released Go 64. And that's kind of riffing off the Commodore 128's Go 64 command. And then there was another one, I think maybe a little later, called A64, presumably for Amiga 64. Now, I don't remember which one, but one of them offered a tool that let you pre-compile or pre-assemble C64 code into Amiga code, so then the emulator could run faster. It would be able to run certain sections of, like say you're trying to emulate a game, you could go through and pre-assemble some of it into Amiga code, which would run faster than having to emulate the 6510. And it could do a certain amount automatically, but it also had provided a tool so that if you were familiar with assembly language, you could better optimize some of the code. So this was a complete waste of time, but it was pretty interesting to me. A waste of time because I still had a real C64 that I could have just went and used. But I remember particularly working on the game, the C64 game Zorro, and pre-compiling or whatever word we want to use, and pre-assembling, pre-converting quite a bit of that game and going through this manual process that was, if I'm remembering, it's a very distant memory now, probably This is 30 years ago I was doing this, but going through and using the tool to speed up Zorro, and eventually I managed to get so Zorro ran almost at full speed on the Amiga. It was a lot of work, but made it playable, and I felt I learned something and accomplished something. Of course, I could have just gone and played Zorro on my actual C64 at that time. And then the last retro C64 emulator I remember using was on MS-DOS and maybe early Windows, but I think it was still the DOS era, called C64S. That emulator, my fondest memory of it is I had just started a summer job in the, well, I guess it was the early to mid 1990s, and it was a really boring office job. Occasionally they had work for me to do, but a lot of the time I was sitting there staring at my computer and waiting for the phone to ring. But I did have a PC there in front of me. So I installed C64S on there, and I got a copy of Superstar Ice Hockey, and I played at least one full season. That's Superstar Ice Hockey lets you play a whole season rather than just playing a game at a time. You can set up and play a whole season and manage your team throughout that. So that's the one and only time in my life where I've managed to find the time to play an entire season of Superstar Ice Hockey. And I guess I got paid for it. I hope my old boss doesn't hear. Well, seriously, there wasn't anything else to do there. It's not like I was slacking off when I had other work, actual work to do. And this reminds me, I just recently found my old Commodore PC50-2. Commodore actually made a line of PC compatibles. I believe this is a 386 class machine. And I got it working again, installed DOS, and got a hard drive installed in it. So the machine works, and I installed C64S on it and got it running. And it's even slower on this machine than I think the one at work I had was probably a 486, and this one is just a 386, so it runs terribly slow. It's very painful even typing in a short basic program on it. But I'm probably going to show that computer and that emulator in an upcoming episode of 8-Bit Show and Tell, so look me up on YouTube if you're interested in that. Okay, those are some retro emulator, retro memories. Talk to you next time.